In the last video, we created a form, and first thing that we realized is that here typing all the time site ID and this remembering which site ID belongs to which site is annoying. So it might be better if we have a drop down here that displays the sites, and we can just select the sites and the site ID should be stored in the background. To achieve this, we have to open this form in the edit mode. Either going here to the edit mode or closing this down and going to forms and open here in edit. Okay, here we are. And now we have to change this part here. So first thing, this is grouped. These are grouped fields, so we have the label and the actual data field. To enter the group, we have to right-click it and say Enter Group or Gruppierung betreten. And now we can individually select those two here. First thing, I will rename this site ID to site. We don't need this ID when we can select sites. So right-click that, say Element, and then there is the title, and I change this to just site. Close this, and now you can see it says site. That's fine. But now we haven't gained anything in respect to drop down here. For doing so, we have also to change this field. And the easiest way is to right click it and say replace by, setzen durch, and select list field here, Listenfeld. And when we've done that, we can right click it again and say element. And now we have to define a bit more. First thing, we want to have this as a drop-down, so aufklappbar drop-down should be yes. Second thing, we have to define where the data should come from. And the data should come from an query, from an SQL query. Don't be afraid, you don't have to type SQL yourself. Just select SQL. And then you click on these three dots here, and it opens a query designer. We need the information from all from the sites, so I add the site table here. And now I add the names and the IDs of the sites to my query. The names should be displayed, the IDs should be saved. Save this and close it again. Okay, and now I close this and open the edit mode, or not the edit, but the not design mode, but the data entry mode. You can see here it says Münsingen, which is nice because when we look here to the tables or graphs, the first site ID here is 1. And I can have this open in parallel. So I change this to Miskovice, save this data set, this record, and refresh here, and now it says site ID 0. If I change this back to Münsingen, save it, refresh here, it says 1. So with this we have a drop down here. And we can do the same for our artifacts subtable here. To do this, I change again to edit mode, click here on the subtable, subform, right click here on type ID, and again replace it by a list field, and then go to column, and again by at the data I say okay, I want to have my data from an SQL query, and I select these three dots, and since I think, let me look, we were at type, so I need the types table, and again I add name and ID, save this and close it. And also it should be droppable. Okay, and the same is true for the material. Again, I replace it by a list field. I select the column and say my data should come from a query, from an SQL query, and it comes from materials. I want to have name and ID there. Save it, close it. And when I go now to the edit mode, I can see here a drop down. Since we don't have any entered any materials yet, we don't see anything here. Still, I save this. And I will change this by entering some materials. Okay, I go back to tables and I go to materials and I add bone, metal, wood, ceramic. Save this, close it, and types I say dagger, pot, and needle, not beetle, needle. Okay, save it, close it. Okay, now I can go back to my form here, and currently I don't see anything. I switch back to the edit mode into the data entry mode, and now I can select here, type should be needle and the material should be metal, and I can start with the next. While we are already here, you see when I go to the here to the next data set while I'm up here. Here is grave ID 1, here is grave ID 0. And this is automatically because the ID is given here and the grave ID is also given here. In the form we don't need this information, we will not enter that, this happens automatically. The same is true here for the ID field itself, we don't want to change that. So we should remove this. I can click this here and remove this here. And also here in the subform, I can remove this column here. And I save this and go back here. And now I don't have to take care for the IDs here. And while we're already there, this ID also can be removed. So let's do that also. Remove this here. Save this again. And now I can work with my data. Okay, with that, let's make it a bit more sensible. We have already a working form here. In the next video I will show you how to add another subform for the individuals and also a subform for the C14 dates.